Hello everybody, my name is Morty, and let's talk about Dauntless. It's been a while since Dauntmon number 1, and we have a ton of news to get through, so here's a quick overview. We will talk about the new Dauntless trailer, a new round of alpha invites, the updated Reddit FHQ, and Dauntless at E3. Let's first take a look at the trailer.
Hunting a behemoth? Is to challenge savagery itself. In the Shattered Isles, nothing is given. If you're going to slay a behemoth, you'll need to become something savage too. If one is to survive, power must be taken. And the smiths of Ramsgate will forge raw power into legend. Take up your blade, Slayer, and fight ice with fire.
I hope this trailer got you as excited as it did me. If not, maybe I can increase your hype just a bit. Let's go through the trailer and try to understand everything. Let's start with the behemoths we saw, and the narrative behind it. We saw a squad of slayers go after what seems to be an ice version of Shriek. According to Discord though, this behemoth is called Screef or Scrave or Scryve or Scraveve? I don't even know. Although Scraveve looks very similar to Shriek, it looks like it's a new behemoth. In the trailer, the squad is not able to defeat Screef and goes out to hunt an Embermane. This is actually the first time we see Embermane in action, and its moveset seems pretty, heated. Defeating Embermane, the squad takes its essence and brings it back to Ramsgate, where the Aethersmith forges new gear for our hero, imbued with Embermane's firepower. Switching from the dual blades to a two-handed sword with fire attacks, the squad returns to turn Screef into a barbecue. This means we will have different elemental behemoths to worry about, and will sometimes have to go out and defeat behemoths of opposing elements to craft new gear, which is, I think, a great way to improve the longevity of the game. If Phoenix Lab introduces a new behemoth, he might be too hard for you even though you already have good gear to defeat instantly, and you need to go to him first to scout his abilities, and afterwards go out and get items that will help you oppose his element. I think that would be really interesting. I never got to play Monster Hunter, so I don't know how it is handled in that series. Let me know if Monster Hunter does something similar with new content. Moving on from the behemoths, we caught a small glimpse at the attack animation for the dual blades, which is the first time we see them in action in the game. The attack animation looks a bit slower than I would like at this moment, but of course we can't tell a lot from the few seconds of footage we got, so I'm still very excited about it. Then we get to see Ramsgate, well, at least a small part of it, but unfortunately we didn't see the big ball. Like, come on Phoenix Labs, why didn't you show us the ball? Well, at least we can get a look at Dauntless's unique art style that really breathes life into the city. I like the mix of realistic architecture with the more cartoon-like art style, and I think Phoenix Labs will do great things with that. We also get to see the airship harbor, or docks, or whatever you call the damn place you land airships at, I have no idea, and the Aethersmith with a big forge in the background. At the very end of the trailer, we get a look at four different armor sets. We see the Embermane set used to fight the Screef, a set that looks more like a winterish outfit, so I'm guessing it's from a dead panga. To the far right in green, I'm pretty sure it's a Drask armor. And the left one, well, I have no idea what that could be, but isn't that what makes it so freaking exciting anyway? Phoenix Labs also updated the official FHQ on the subreddit, and they sent out another huge wave of Tech Alpha invites. 2,000 invites went out last week, sadly, still only for people living in Northwest America. But with the amount of new people being invited into the Alpha servers in NA, I am hopeful that Phoenix Labs is getting ready to launch a more international server test soon. The updated FHQ provides us with a little bit of info. First, we will be getting behemoths that are so deadly, they have been named and deemed legendary for us to hunt down. While we won't be getting raid-like content which supports more than 4 slayers at a time, this might hint at a kind of heroic encounter you need a squad for to complete, but we'll have to see. Furthermore, there won't be any pets at launch, though they are excited about the idea of having non-combat pets available at some point. Don't mistake them for combat pets, that is something they don't want to implement. And a bit of sad news at the end for people like me who love cooking in real life and games. Dauntless will not be featuring a cooking profession at launch, though we might end up getting it added later if we yell loud enough. I want to make Emberman stew and grilled shriek with mango sauce, damn it! On Discord, we also got the clarification that there will in fact be a premium currency in-game to buy cash shop items. But the currency is not part of the Founders Packs. This is a fairly standard practice for any free-to-play game that you convert real-life money into a premium currency and with that you buy stuff. And, at long last, Dauntless has announced that they will be at E3, though they will not have their own booth, so don't go looking for them. Instead, they will appear live on 3 different occasions, as you can see here, so be sure to tune in. We don't know what they will show or what they won't show, but I am gonna watch and make a video about it for you. So, that was about all the new info I had for you on the game. I hope you liked the video, and if you did, don't forget to hit the like button. Subscribe for more Dauntless in the future, and stay tuned for my E3 coverage coming up next week.